Peter Uspensky, in one of his books, mentions that the Bible has 12 different levels of meaning. And if you know what those 12 different levels are, then you can discuss the Bible. One of the things that is in there is the tree of knowledge and the forbidden fruit. The tree of knowledge is exactly that, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Good for the overlords, and evil for the overlords, should you find out what's really going on. Planet Earth is a business. It's also has a game aspect, which is most of the people here don't know it's a business, which I'm sure is quite fun for the people running it. The allegory or symbolism there is the fruit was actually not an apple, but something else similar to an apple, and it has a five-pointed seed case arrangement. And what this is alluding to is if you cut this thing in half and look at the seed cases and turn one half over, you get symbolism of the basics for hyperdimensional physics, which is the technology that the interstellar space cultures use, the way we use electricity for everything. They use hyperdimensional free energy physics to do all of their things. And some of them look down and laugh at us with our internal combustion engines and electricity. The reason this wound up in the Bible is some people are always trying to tell the sleeping people that it is a business and a game they're involved in, and the penalty for doing that is death. For example, what happened to Yeshua of Nazareth. Another person you'll find in the Bible. This leads me to, I wanted to discuss why would the current local administrations not be willing to disclose what's going on. And I'm going to tell you why. People like Nassim Harameen and others are talking about this new to us idea of humans and planets and galaxies all being in the shape of an electromagnetic, let's say, shaped like an apple. This is the one of the basic structures of universes, of the games of universes, or this universe, the construction, how it's constructed, how it's held together. And knowing this, that a person, the actual spiritual being, is a small electromagnetic pattern or presence that the indestructible spirit is using to interrelate with the matter, energy, space, and time game, there are weapons to knock that being and their electromagnetic bubble out of their body. And in that state, they can be electronically implanted with ideas that are not their own, turned into slaves, transported to other areas. And what's happened here is large numbers of beings were popped out of their bodies, and imprisoned in a thing where there is no time, no awareness, no space. These people have been there for over 70 million years and not knowing that. And it's a pretty scary technology. So if someone can simply pop you out of your body and you don't die, they now have you. This is what the governments of Earth were facing in 1947-ish when Roswell happened. So there's nothing you can do against it. This can be done to an entire planet. This can be just bang, everyone's out of their body, everyone's vacuumed up, the entire population of a planet. And either, I don't think it can be killed per se, because everyone's immortal, but you can be tortured, you can be imprisoned, you can be memory erased and turned into a slave anywhere in any galaxy. So it's pretty overwhelming for someone whose maximum weapon is an atomic bomb, which they couldn't launch more than a few miles above the surface of the Earth. That's the downside. The upside is the current administration here doesn't know how to do that anymore. And hundreds of thousands of beings who were imprisoned are being released. And they have all of their abilities pre the big disaster that happened here. And most of them are staying to help out with the situation. And we see them as the crystal and indigo children who are being born now. Some are from other areas in the galaxy, but a lot of them are either former inhabitants of Earth or former inhabitants of the nearby planets who also were participants in the big disaster that happened here when this was set up as a business by the people that the exopolitics group talk about. Things are never completely 100% black, otherwise it wouldn't be a game. So on the planet there has been the group of people who know what's going on trying to tell the main body, and these are the Hidden Mystery Schools, the Great White Brotherhood, whatever you want to call them, and because they're the 1%, actually 1/10,000th of 1%, they can't come out and do their business in public because they'll get slammed like Jesus did. So they do it through schools, and they establish a school and they do an event to change the course of history. And these events are seen as our history, but they actually are concocted by higher schools. Like 9/11 was an event, a negative event that was concocted to get a change in the history. And these mystery schools lately, in the last few thousand years, we know who the famous people were, and these are people like Buddha, Jesus, Peter Uspensky, Gandhi, John Lennon. These are all cosmic events that try to raise the the bar in a positive way. Now, in a book called The Theory of Celestial Influence by Rodney Collin, he has a section called The Cycle of Civilizations. And a civilization lasts for about 800 years, 400 years in, it starts to decline, 400 years out. And eight of them in a row, 8 times 8 is 64, is one cycle of civilizations. And the game here is if you can win two consecutive cycles of civilization octaves, you win. And the crossover point between two 6,400 year long cycles of civilization is in 2035. Which is what 2012 is about. Between 2012 and 2035, the bad guys are going to try to have the planet go down into darkness and suppression. And the people who want to have a different kind of fun are looking for peace, love, and harmony, progress, adventure. So that is the real clash of forces, and the 2012 event is possibly going to be used as an excuse for causing trouble, but the Mayans never said it was the end of the world. They said it was the end of an age, and this happens to be a breath of the Earth's a living being. It's the 25,556, whatever it is. They knew that the Earth is a living being. Half of that, around 12,500 years, is the inhalation, energy, light, breath, good things coming in, and then the exhalation, darkness, or like night, day and night. We're just coming out of the exhalation stage of the Earth into an inhalation, and things will get better. This is inevitable. The game for the suppressive people is they do know that, but they still can try to have that next 12,500 years be suppressive and dark. So those who don't want that have solar and galactic size forces behind them. So it might go fairly easily. Well, I want to show you something and the reason I'm showing you this is not the reason you'll think I'm showing this when you get to the end of it. I'm just it's something that I know that will be interesting. This is going to be symbols the circle in symbology stands for infinity, or the cyclic nature of the universe, and that is a gigantic broad subject. Just if you look at if 25,000 years is the breath of the Earth as a living being, how long is its lifetime, and what part of a culture does it belong to, and how long has that culture been around? Just scales of time. Now if you split this, you can see the stuff in the Egyptian hieroglyphs. This is the symbol of the day and night breath in and out of all sections of the cosmos. This is Egyptian for coffin. And in their attempts to have an afterlife, they've taken the split circle mean infinite or eternal and put it on each end of the coffin, and there is that symbol you see all over Egypt. I'm going to combine this with something else. And this has happened over the last 2,000 years. That is the timeline, a timeline. And at the bottom of this, you have this symbol. I'm not familiar with what this represents, but it's upside down cross, paganism. This is a time, you can also look at this as a human body, where you have the instinctive functions down here. The second version of this, as time went on, was the time of the Templars, etc., where you have the cross in the middle, the Templar cross. A very emotional time, people going to war over religious ideas and chivalry and all of that stuff. This is mankind growing up, actually. This is goes along with the cycle of civilizations. The bottom part is barbarism, the primitive culture, swords and stone, and then coming up to ideas of chivalry and heraldry and religion. And these are cosmic forces being expressed through mankind. This is the mechanicality of mankind is trapped as part of the communication medium between the planets as living beings. Per the Earth is a living being and breathing every 25,000 years. There are thoughts and emotions on that level of which we are pawns unless you go to a conscious school and get out of that. Go to a higher school. Control over yourself. A little further on, 2,000 years ago, we had mankind's consciousness getting close to the top, and this is Christianity and Jesus and all those ideas, brotherhood of man, honesty, decency, trying to get rid of the Roman Empire, suppressing people. And the most unpopular piece of all would be this. Which is, you'll find this all over the Church of Scientology's literature, which is at the very top, the intellectual function. Ron Hubbard figured out the technology of how to solve all of the problems that plague mankind in a human body, and for which he was attacked by those who rule us. And this was also a conscious school, a play where the teacher leaves the planet. As John Lennon did, his octave was doing the Beatles, and then this, during the second octave, where he was the peace person, do re mi fa interval. Those are words from the eight cycles of any process in this universe has eight cycles to it, and they're the same as the musical notes, so it's called a do re mi fa do re. Do re mi fa interval is where you can get in to an octave or process or change it. And John Lennon was assassinated at that time. Gandhi did everything that he did in India, made a massive change, got rid of the British, and at the do re mi fa interval of the next octave, and he was asked to do something else, he was assassinated and he left the planet. I think Socrates, someone in the Greek schools, was asked to drink hemlock and kill himself. This is the same kind of thing where the He's inventing science, mathematics, making a culture, bringing people up, and at the second part of his lifetime, he leaves at the Mipha interval. And this is a play of a cosmic school. Peter Ospensky, same thing, massive effort to spread fourth way schools around the world. And the teachers are getting better at this. At the very end, he deliberately took control of how he left the planet. He'd finished all his writings, set up his work, and left. George Gurdjieff was not able to ever get his stuff written down as he wanted. He died in out of an auto accident in the at the Mipha interval of his second novel. He had established what he did, written some books, got some schools started, influences around the world, and then the teacher leaves, having created an historical change. And I'm going to mention, because I mentioned the H word, Ron Hubbard, that a lot of people are not going to like that, but Ron Hubbard discovered the Martian influence in Egypt. The Brotherhood of the Snake was in his early materials. He discovered the Illuminati in 1964-65-ish in England, and they didn't like that. And he was talking about higher IQs for everyone and peace and the end of insanity on the planet. So that's why he was stopped. He's part of this chain of ascension of mankind, and has been slammed so hard because he's the most recent person, I guess. If we'd been around to observe what happened to Jesus, I imagine it was much more horrific than it's been portrayed. So don't let that pull you away from my discourse on the history of how conscious schools or the inner circle of mankind create events to change history in a positive way, which is part of the game of planet Earth. Otherwise it would just be troglodytes working in the salt mines. So there is something afoot now. People who need to be here have already arrived and are hard at work on remedying the situation. And why this is happening now is it's a good opportunity because of the changeover between the two octaves of civilizations happening in December, just a few months from now, in 2035. So those who work with the cosmology know that this is an ideal time to set planet Earth free. And there are many forms of this. For example, the many people who talk about the 12-stranded DNA ascension of mankind automatically because of the cosmology of the universe, changing what we are. That may or may not be. It's evidential, circumstantial, based on the fossil record, that there have been massive extinctions and changes in a cyclic way on this planet. But time is controllable, malleable, can be different. However, the galactic government is here to babysit the undoing of the slavery on planet Earth. And it's going to happen. And is well underway. Now, why these symbols that I've shown you? There's a problem with if you knew this kind of stuff that I'm talking about tonight, 10,000 years ago, how could you talk to barbarians about it? But you want to make progress, so you have to speak to them in a way they can understand. And these circular things represent immortality, eternity. It also, all the planets are round. Sun is round, moon is round. People can relate to the sun and the moon, the cyclicness of them, the dependability. So you create sun cults, god, moon cults. But this is so other people in the ascension business know who you are and what you're doing. So I'm introducing the idea of an afterlife to a primitive culture in the hopes of making them a little less instinctive and violent. And then we get into the time is breath, breath of Brahma, day and night, good and evil, up and down, female goddesses, gods, then the upside down cross. These also relate to the chakras. So the once you introduce this, this is many things, human body, the chakras, eternity is still a factor there, afterlife is a factor. This is the lower chakras and primitive man, where man's, we have to solve the problems with food, water, medicine, shelter, security. Introduction of agriculture and arrows for hunting and protection, and civilization as per the Middle Eastern flowering of civilization. And remember, this is a flowering brought about after some disaster that happened 13,500 years ago, whatever it was, a flood or a comet or a war. This is basically the Templars' time. Maybe 900 A.D. to 1400 A.D. And a Christian guy once told me, he said, how important is Jesus? He said, he's the reason we have B.C. and A.D. That's how important this guy was. Then we have the Christian era, the Middle Ages. Things are getting better and better all the time. Christianity brought, and although they did it in a barbarous way, brought an end to a lot of the primitive way we were behaving. I say overall Christendom is better than barbarism, but we're still living in a tribal culture, in my opinion. And we have the current age, which is the new age, which is the era of spirituality, peace, love, brotherhood, and all of those things which started in the 60s and are still being dealt with now. And where we are is right here at the top now, between now and the very pinnacle here with the 2035. And between octaves, there's a small space called a Kairos time, where anything is possible, all things are possible. And if you want to change the next octave, that's the best time to strike. So everyone's gearing up for that, and that is the the war in heaven, the war between good and evil. It's the only game in town. And that's a little peek at what is actually going on behind war in the Middle East and the election and global warming and global schmorming and all kinds of things. Hopefully this is a time when the largest, at least 51% of the human beings here will realize they're asleep and maybe they should wake up, and we could build a place that would be a lot more fun. We have bad management here, a really careless attitude towards the planet, and this is part of the growing up or re-civilization of the planet, and it's taken many thousand years to recover from whatever happened, and it's been a lot of work by the inner circle of mankind to drag things back from the brink of disaster and extinction. And as Carrie Cassidy says, I have to say, there used to be a one world government. And it wasn't a globalist kind of government, it was one world. And Newtopia is the reestablishment of that government. And under that government, it's illegal to have small independent jurisdictions like a national country. So those who are operating nations are operating illegally from the historic perspective of how this planet is to be run. So none of the laws of any of the nation states who are operating illegally apply to citizens of Newtopia. So we are free of you, free at last, free at last, free at last.